Torey Hayden, One Child. The true story of a tormented six-year-old and the brilliant teacher who reached out. Dedication to Sheila R., of course. I'm asked repeatedly about the poem on my office wall. It seems only right that they should know the child who wrote it. And I only hope I have been half as good a writer. Prologue. For the better part of my adult life, I have been working with emotional disturbed children. The autumn of my freshman year in college, I took a volunteer position in a day program for disturbed and disadvantaged preschoolers. From that season, I have remained captivated by the perplexing aspects of mental illness in childhood. Since that time, I have acquired 3 degrees. Devoted several years as a teacher's aide, a teacher, a university instructor, and a psychiatric researcher, lived in 5 states, and worked in private daycare centers, public schools, locked psychiatric wards, and state institutions, all the while pursuing the elusive answers to these children. The magic keys that will finally open them to my understanding. Yet, within me, I have long known there are no keys, and that for some children, even love will never be enough. But belief in human soul escapes all reason and flies beyond the frail fingers of our knowledge. I am often asked about my work. Perhaps the commonest question is, isn't it frustrating? Isn't it frustrating, the college student asks, to live day to day with violence, poverty, drug and alcohol addiction, sexual and physical abuse, neglect and apathy? Isn't it frustrating, the regular classroom teacher asks, to work so hard for so little in return? Isn't it frustrating, they all ask, to know your greatest success will probably never have more than an approximation of normalcy? To know that these very little children have been sentenced to live a life which by our standards will never be productive, contributing, or normal. Isn't it frustrating? No, it isn't really. They are simply children. Frustrating at times, as all children are. But they are also gratifyingly compassionate and hauntingly perceptive. Madness alone seems to allow the whole truth to be spoken. But these children are more. They are courageous. While we turn on the evening news to hear of new excitements and conquest quests on some distant front, we miss the very real dramas that play themselves out among us. This is unfortunate, because there is bravery here unsurpassed by any outside event. Some of these children live with such haunted nightmares in their heads that every move is fraught with unknown terror. Some live with such violence and perversity that it cannot be captured in words. Some live without dignity, accorded animals. Some live without love. Some live without hope. Yet they endure. And for the most part they accept, not knowing any other way. This book tells of only one child. It was not written to evoke pity, nor was it intended to bring praise on one teacher, nor to depress those who have found peace in not knowing. Instead, it is an answer to the question of frustration in working with the mentally ill. It is a song to the human soul, because this little girl is like all my children, like all of us. She is a survivor.